College football on ABC is presented by K Jewelers. Number 24 Florida State facing a tough challenge at Dope Campbell Stadium. North Carolina has turned around its season with 5 wins in the last 6 games. And the Tar Heels have life in the ACC title chase. FSU got an early Christmas gift today. They are now in control of the Atlantic Division because both North Carolina State and Maryland stumbled. They are the only team in the division with 1 loss. In the Coastal Division, North Carolina trails by 2 games in the loss column, but it is to a Virginia Tech team that they play at home next week. They can cut the lead in half. Good afternoon, everybody. Mike Patrick, Greg James, it's great to have you with us. The remarkable thing after all the suspensions and dismissals and injuries for North Carolina, that we're talking about them in the same conversation about winning a division is remarkable.
It's unbelievable. I just was telling Butch Davis on the phone. I said, you know, Butch, congratulations for what all you've accomplished. He goes, what do you mean? I go, you have endured. He's done a great job of coaching this football team. Sitting down watching them on tape yesterday, I was really impressed with the fact that his team still plays hard. Now, today in this ball game, North Carolina's defense has to step up. Last year in their loss on a Thursday night, they gave up 395 yards to Christian Ponder through the air. The defensive front 7 have got to put pressure on Ponder tonight because the secondary, I think, is a weakness. They have some players back there, but the suspensions, the in and out of this guy and that guy, they're vulnerable to the pass today.
FSU has a big task. They have to come back after that heartbreaking loss against North Carolina State last week. They were on the 4-yard line going in for what would have been the winning touchdown. Instead, they fumble, lose the game.
I was in the booth for that game, and I stood up there calling that, and it's a touchdown all the way, but it didn't happen. There are no layups in college football. So what has to happen today? Christian Ponder has to forget about the mistakes that he's made. He's had 6 turnovers in the last 2 games. Mike, you and I were here and we watched him against Boston College on a Saturday afternoon. His defense bailed him out in that ball game. He's got to forget those mistakes. And there were some issues there with an arm and a versus sack, this and that. There's the play you talked about last Thursday night. A routine play action pass, tight end wide open. It just did not happen. He's got to forget that and play like he is capable of playing in this ball game today.
You would have to think the emotion would be on the Seminoles' side. It is homecoming. They're going to have a huge crowd, and this is a huge game for FSU. We'll be back with the opening kickoff. North Carolina and Florida State right after these messages.
ESPN College Football on ABC, presented by K Jewelers.
BlackBerry have teamed up to keep your business moving. Introducing the BlackBerry Torch. AT&T, rethink possible.
Once that adrenaline starts pumping, you just gotta embrace it.
Bear Grylls is the ultimate man of adventure.
Can he take on my sport?
My sport.
My sport to the next level?
I challenge.
Bear to take on the chain of adventure.
Only got one shot at this. Amazing. Woo, let's give it a go.
Watch me take on the chain of adventure at DegreeMen.com. Degree for Men, Adventure Antiperspirant.
It won't let you down.
This is Dr. Love!
And this is Dr. Pepper Cherry. It's got a little kiss of cherry flavor.
You want cherry? How about a little kiss?
Cherry. Trust me, I'm a doctor.
Tucker Alexander.
He turned down an epic Hawaiian hot tub party for a multiplayer paintball tourney. Oozes before jacuzzis, as they say.
GoldenEye's back. Get your friends. Rated T.
Ridiculed for unfairly playing as Odd Job, Phil Lang retorted, Odd Job owns you. Feel his ownage.
GoldenEye's back. Get your friends. Rated teen.
One of the great traditions in college football. There is something very primal and entertaining about this Chief Osceola at midfield. That's just really cool.
I like it.
You do that on your farm, don't you, on your ranch?
Yep, and I try to keep all four hooves on the ground at the same time.
North Carolina has won only once in this 17-game series. That was back in 2001. The tie came here in 1986. Tar Heels will get the ball first.
Man, how about the ACC, Mike? It's just unbelievable. The unpredictability of this conference, and if you're a coach in this conference, you have a lot of sleepless nights.
And a lot of teams still alive as well as we get down to the last month of the season. Elzey and Searcy are deep for North Carolina. Searcy averaging 26 yards a return. He wears number 21 in light blue and white. And one of the great kickoff men in the country, Dustin Hopkins, who has 29 touchbacks and 51 tries, scrunches one along the ground, kicks it out of bounds. That'll be a big break for the Tar Heels.
Ball will be placed at the 40-yard line. First down.
They get it all the way up at the 40.
Highly out of character for the kicking team here at Florida State. Normally a real strong plus for their ball club.
Hopkins usually puts it about 8 yards deep in the end zone. T.J. Yates, the much maligned senior quarterback out of Marietta, Georgia. But he's having a pretty good senior season. Number one in the ACC. 66.1% of his passes have been completed. 12 touchdowns, only 4 interceptions. Johnny White is the tailback out of the eye. Play action fake to him. And Yates completes his first throw to the 25-yard line, and it's Dwight Jones who leads this club in catches and yards. Hit him for 37. How's that for a first play, Craig?
How about this? If you look on the outside, the play action's to the right. There were the first 3 steps by Jones, hard to the inside. The corner bit on it, and a nice, well-designed, you know they worked on it, expecting to have that kind of bite on play action on the first play of the game.
John Shoup, the offensive coordinator, said we need to try to give them looks that say we're running and throw out of that, and looks that we're throwing and run out of that. White. Close to the 21-yard line.
This North Carolina football team up front, they've had a lot of different variations. 7 or 8 will play on the left side. They're a true freshman, James Hurst, 68. He's a good football player, as is Jonathan Cooper at left guard. Their backs and receivers, Johnny White, number 34. We'll talk about him all day. Second in the conference in all-purpose yards a game at 122 a crack. He's pretty darn good.
2nd and 8. They bunch the wide receivers to the left. Pressure coming, hangs in there, throws over the middle to Ed Barham, his tight end, and Barham is down to the 6. It's going to be 1st and goal. Xavier Rhodes made the tackle.
All of that respect for Johnny White in the backfield has the Florida State defense and those linebackers peeking and looking for 34, and the tight end is able to get open in the middle of the field. This T.J. Yates is a different player this year. Part of the reason North Carolina has been able to endure through all of the suspensions. He's played good management football.
White with Curtis Byrd in front of him. 1st and goal, Tar Heels. White. Johnny White, touchdown. There is something about this group of kids that absolutely refuses to give up. And they strike first here at homecoming at Florida State.
You got the tight end or the H-back that goes in motion. And instead of following him all the way to the other side, White feels the opening and the lack of gap responsibility by Florida State.
Dender. This guy ought to get a bunch of votes.
Well, he lost John Blake, who had a resignation in the middle of the season, replaced by another coach.
tackle on that one made by Kendrick Burney, who has just come back. Rodney Smith made the catch. Burney caught up in that NCAA investigation and the North Carolina investigation. Quinn, an All-American candidate. Marvin Austin, an All-American candidate. They're gone. Michael McAdoo, still it's undetermined what's going to happen to him. Sturdivant was out for 5 games because he was hurt. I mean, it has just been an absolute nightmare for these guys. Burt Reed makes another catch, and he'll be stopped at the 22-yard line.
Well, the one thing I like about Everett Withers and the coaching staff that they've done here is they've reminded these players that it has happened. It's over, and you got to play. You know, you're only guaranteed 12 opportunities to play each season, and I think they've coached them up and done a great job of getting players in there and told them, look, you weren't going to play until next year, but now it's your turn, so let's go with it.
Ponder goes to the shotgun on first down. They spot it at the 23. And they'll run it inside the 10. Jermaine Thomas pounding over defenders. Somebody may have had a word on the sideline because they're playing with a little more heat right now.
Yeah, that defense finally woke them up and the crowd finally got into it. Ponder with the option, getting it outside to the 0-9 leading rusher on this football team, Thomas. And he lays the shoulder pad to him, and that even picks the sidelines up more.
He'll get another opportunity off the left side inside the 5, knocked out of bounds at the 3.
But you know,
one more thing about these suspensions, Craig. This is such a proud university of its academic record and its compliance, and it deserves to be proud the way they have conducted themselves over the years. This has really stung them and really hurt them.
And I think Butch Davis, who prides himself on doing it the right way, it stung him.
Absolutely.
This should be considered the hardest coaching job season that Butch has ever had to deal with, and he's done a great job of keeping them on track.
Ponder spreads the field, stands in the pocket. Now he takes off and won't be able to pick up anything, taken down at the 5-yard line, and it was Quan Sturdivant who was right there. Tydrick Powell got in his face and made him flush out of the pocket so Sturdivant could pick him off. He's missed 5 games with hamstring injuries. Well, you can say that just about everybody on this defense has missed X number of games because of something.
Well, you know what? After you miss the wide open receiver that gets at the very, very back middle of the end zone, don't force it. That's a good no throw.
Third and goal for Ponder. Thompson checks back in as the running back. Ponder throws to the end zone. Touchdown. Willie Halstead, known more than anything for his blocking, picks up his 5th touchdown catch of the year.
Going against Fan Troy over here, they thought they might have an opportunity to have some big plays today, and a nice job of Halstead driving off Fan Troy before he comes back to the flag. And a nice job of Ponder delivering the ball.
Well, I like Halstead down here because of his size. He's 6'3". The point after by Dustin Hopkins, and we're tied at 7. The Seminoles, stung early, come back to tie it with 7:49 to go, first quarter from Tallahassee. Ponder on that last drive that tied it up hit all 4 of his throws to 4 different receivers. Halstead caught the last one, number 82, with his 5th touchdown grab of the season. And now Hopkins will get another chance to kick it off to Searcy. Kicking from the 30-yard line, it is remarkable that he is better than 50% on touchbacks. 5 yards deep, bobbled, and they'll keep it there. That is touchback number 30 on the year for Hopkins. Now for an update, Robert Flores in our Times Square studio. Robert.
All right, Mark Tycho Bell, studio update. Illinois needs this two-point conversion to extend their game in triple overtime with Michigan. Instead, they can't convert. Wolverines survive. It's the highest scoring game of the season thus far. TCU, touchdown pass from Andy Dalton. They lead Utah 7-0. Mike.
Robert, I thought you were talking about the opening of basketball season, 67-65. Play action fake. Complete pass to Adams. Joshua Adams up to the 35.
Now, this Florida State defense normally does not allow receivers running wide open like that. Up front on the defensive line, Marcus White's a good player. Brandon Jenkins, really active, has 8 sacks on the season. Linebackers, all of them are pretty good. Kendall Smith leads them in tackles with 60. And in the secondary, Greg Reed gets all the publicity, but Xavier Rhodes, North Carolina coaches believe he's just as good.
Again, a running formation. They've been trying to throw out of these. And it has worked very well so far against this very fast FSU defense. White this time is going to run. And almost every play, Craig, that we have seen, if they have run out of a running formation, it's been stuffed. If they've thrown out of a passing formation, they haven't been successful.
Yeah, and there's 8 men in the box against this formation here, Mike. So Florida State's defense, they felt the tendency. They got up expecting the run. And the freshman, the true freshman, Werner out there, showing a little might here in November.
Loss of a yard, 2nd and 11. Mark Stoops, of that familiar Stoops coaching family. They've all been successful. Yates gives to White. I bet there are guys with the last name Stoops who aren't even part of that family who are getting coaching jobs because of them.
Well, and I told you the story about how the last time after we were here against Boston College, I went up in the coaches' offices to watch games at the end of the day, and Mrs. Stoops was up there, the mother, and she was fantastic. She had such a vibrant personality and talking about strategy in the game, time of possession, and I guarantee you, Mark and Mike and Bob, they said, yes, ma'am.
He has totally turned this defensive program around, which is exactly what Jimbo Fisher was looking for when he went out and got him away from Arizona. Who moves first is always the question. And it's going to be North Carolina.
Number 68, offense, 5 yards, still third down.
James Hurst, the true freshman who was a 5-star prospect out of high school, the guilty party.
Yeah, Butch Davis told me that he's really talented, maybe perhaps playing as well as anybody, but it's up and down. A true freshman on the road, a big game like this, feels the energy of the crowd and just a little antsy.
Third and long for T.J. Yates, 4-man rush. Best rushing team in the country as far as pass pressure, and Yates has to throw it toward the sideline, intended for Adams, but off his hands and out of bounds. This Florida State Seminole defense, they come after you. 33 sacks this year, an average of 4.13 a game, number one in the nation.
And you saw another guy there, Christian Jones, number 7, making that hit after the throw, a true freshman out of Winter Park, Texas. And so this team just has depth and talent and a really good defensive coordinator in Stoops to teach him.
Fiegels to kick to Reed, who waits at the 25. Returnable kick. Reed. Taken down at the 21-yard line. 2001, the number 6 Florida State Seminoles lost for the only time against North Carolina. Seminoles came in undermanned, committed 5 turnovers, and the Tar Heels took quick advantage. Led by freshman quarterback Darian Durant, as well as Ronald Curry, North Carolina scored 3 times in the air. North Carolina also ran it in a couple of times, a 41-9 win. Their only victory in 17 tries against FSU. Seminoles start from the 21. Ponder out in the flat to Reed. Would they like those flanker screens, those bubble screens, whatever you want to call them?
Okay, so you and I were here on that a couple Saturdays ago when they played Boston College, and that ball that he threw right there after being hurt with a bursa sack, which we did not know at the time. We knew that there was something going on.
Because the ball was taking an awful long time to get there.
It got there today, didn't it?
Yes, it did.
A little bit more zip. And Ponder's had to deal with against Oklahoma.
Number eight, 10 yards from the end of the run. Still second down.
Eight is Taiwan Easterling, one of the wide receivers.
So against Oklahoma, he gets hit in his tricep, and it swole up, and he had to deal with that. Now, and then Ponder went through, the bursa sack in the elbow, and he got a nick on his wrist. So he's had a lot of different things going on with that throwing arm.
And I've known people who had that bursa sack explode on them. It's a terribly painful injury. A
couple of different times they had to remove a lot of fluid.
Yeah.
I don't know my centimeters and millimeters, but it was a bunch.
They'll try to keep it on the ground with Thompson. Gets a couple to the 20, and it was Kevin Riddick, number 48. One of those really hard-working guys that doesn't have great size or great speed, but always seems to get the job done. He's number two on this team in tackles, with 45 this year coming into this game. Ponder now faces second and 12. Play action fake. Complete to Easterling, but not much there. Good defense by Kendrick Burney. An all-ACC performer playing in only his second game of the season.
Jimbo Fisher here, the offensive coordinator, head coach, play caller, all that stuff. You know, he's trying to feel out this North Carolina defense. Doesn't want to make a mistake on this end of the field early like they've done it in the past.
Third and long. Ponder had that one tipped. That could have been a big mistake. Quentin Copels, who is playing only because the defensive line has been decimated by dismissals and suspensions, got a hand up on that one. He's very talented.
Well, this is a guy, Copels, who used to play on the outside, but because of lack of depth and all of those suspensions, they had to move him to the inside. So he's got the ability and the wherewithal. He understands get your hands up because he's used to doing that on the outside.
From his tackle spot this year, he has 5.5 sacks, 11 tackles behind the line of scrimmage, and has made 42 tackles. For a defensive lineman to have 42 tackles is remarkable. The crowd thinks that thing was touched by a North Carolina player. Florida State finally picks it up after a kick of 40 yards, but the officials say no, didn't touch anybody.
No, I think if anything, it may have touched the Florida State player, but
I think it went right through the wicket.
Yep.
Heels take over at the 32. White out of the eye. Two wide receivers. White will get the carry. Not much, maybe a half a yard. Saturday night football, a Pac-10 showdown, number 15, Arizona, heading north to take on number 13, Stanford. Saturday night football presented by Southwest Airlines on ABC tonight at 8 Eastern. 7 the nation, we'll see number 12, Missouri at Texas Tech. Go to ESPN.com and search maps to see where you can find your game. Jones, Boyd, and Highsmith in as wide receivers. And they'll go to the tight end, Barham, and he can't handle it.
Man, the explosion of that Florida State defensive line coming off the ball. I mean, that you hear coaches when they're preparing to play against Florida State always talk about explodes off the line. Watch how they just boom. And Yates is feeling that. And when you play Florida State, offensive linemen better be ready.
Their goal is to meet at the quarterback. Whew. Yates has hit only one of his last four after going 3 for 3 to start the ball game. 5 men, they don't get there. Yates deep down the middle, and he he has Jones. Dwight Jones for a touchdown. 67 yards. With protection, T.J. Yates with time to stand in the pocket, and he hit his speedster Jones, who coming into this game had 20 catches for 379 yards in the last three games, and he's at it again today, 3 for 107. This guy is on fire. What a pretty throw by Yates. The pocket was just starting to collapse.
Okay, but I want to watch it. I want to teach young wide receivers, if any are out there listening and watching this thing, watch how Jones runs to the ball. He doesn't have his hands out. Jones has to sprint to go get this football. Did you see how he just kept it and he really worked his arms? He sprinted to the football. This ball's put up right where it's got to be, but man, that's an outstanding job of Jones identifying and seeing. At first when it took off, I thought, boy, he may not be able to get up to this football, and Jones just went and got it. So that's protection up front. They came with the five, allowed the deep ball to happen, and Yates, man, this season, he's really played well. 66% of his passes he's completing, and that, I think, a real key for North Carolina's success.
He had 15 interceptions a year ago, and everybody was all over him. He's only had 4 this year. He's really turned his game around. And when you get protection like that, and you've got talent around you, and remember, Little was a great wide receiver, one of the best in the country.
No doubt.
He fell victim to all this stuff that was going on.
And Yates came out of spring fighting for the starting job.
Absolutely.
Remember watching the spring game thinking, well, who's going to be the quarterback for North Carolina this year? That was the least of their concerns.
Yeah.
Little did they know.
Well, it is T.J. Yates. That is for sure. His quarterback rating of 146-16 is second in the ACC coming in. And once again, Florida State stunned by North Carolina's offensive prowess. Reed from the 3-yard line has the seam, trips over a pile of bodies to the 27. Here's Robert Flores.
All right, my New York Life studio update has Boise State on top of Hawaii. Jeremy Avery, watch the block right there. That keys his 14-yard touchdown run. They went for 2 and missed it. They've just added a touchdown and point after, so now the lead is 13-0 early second quarter. Meantime, TCU, same score up on Utah. Battle of undefeated there in Salt Lake. Mike.
And Utah, Robert, thought they had some payback coming this year. They really got waxed a season ago by Texas Christian. Maybe in the process of having it happen again. That's a pretty good football team.
But you saw Andy Dalton's numbers there. 6 of 7 quarterback for TCU.
Yeah.
He's one of those really superstars in college football most people don't know about.
Thomas with the carry gets a couple. Let's take a look at this week's BCS standings brought to you by Vizio. Oregon number 1. Playing an undermanned Washington team.
So much for the distractions at Auburn with Cam Newton, 62 points.
So the only team in the top 10 so far that's trailing is number 5, Utah, and that's against number 3, TCU. That one's complete to Burt Reed, but he's out of bounds.
And you saw Wisconsin down the ladder in that top 10. They started out slow today, but then really picked it up, and I think Wisconsin, they're sitting nice. So is Michigan State. Michigan State's got a real winnable schedule out.
Yes,
and in
they
the
do.
Big Ten, it's the if there's a three-way tie, it's the highest-ranked BCS school in there.
Ponder, very patient, and again, another dropped ball. Reed, that's the third ball they've dropped. They've also fumbled a couple of times. One of those was overturned on replay. You got to hold on to the football.
Well, you know what that means? 3 drops now. That's 2 series they've had to give up because of the drops. So instead of having the chains move, you've got to punt the football away to an offense that now has hit on a couple of deep balls, one that they just had for a long touchdown.
A lot of quarterbacks will start to lose patience. Searcy on a booming punt, signals fair catch, makes it at the 18. If you're a quarterback, you go over to the sideline, you start yelling at guys. You got to hold on to some of these things.
Well, you know what? You remember back at the start of this football season, Christian Ponder, they explained it to us like that. Christian Ponder, they said, it's like that he's over a guy that's in, you know, physics, and everybody else is in elementary school out as the wide receivers. And so they've had to come on. And I thought the wide receivers had been doing a good job. But today, they've started out slow.
Well, a couple of these guys are going to be put in detention to follow up your example here.
Yeah.
Heels will start at the 18. White has not been much of a factor yet, neither has the entire running game. Yates dumps it to his tight end, Taylor. And Taylor will take it across to 25. Super speed, super strength, even a super brain can't protect you from the suspicious minds of your in-laws. ABC's No Ordinary Family, all new Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on ABC. Second and three. White hitting the backfield. The first man that hit him was Nick Moody, the safety. Moody just, he's the eighth guy in the box, and he is in the backfield before they have a chance to get anything started.
Yeah, you know what, right now you're talking about those tendencies on offense. So the eighth guy comes walking up in here. So now there are eight guys that are up there against that run, and there's just no way you can get against that. And it's a nice job of going to it by Moody to the ball carrier.
He's not even going to bother reading anything, is he? He's just going to get in the backfield. Third and seven, Yates in the gun. Four-man rush, pretty decent protection. Now Yates takes off and knocked down at the 24-yard line. Good coverage downfield. That's why Yates took off. Brandon Jenkins ends up making the tackle.
You know what happened there was Mark Stoops decided to do a little work up front with the defensive line. They had what in the old days some people called elder hands.
Now they're going to hit him anyway, aren't they? Ponder, good protection. That one was almost dropped. It was caught by Halstead, but the ball ended up on his hip. Taken down by Searcy. Nice throw by Ponder.
And this ball, even this one here, Halstead had to use his hip, it looked like, to bring it in. Whoops, yeah, hang on to it there. But really nice job of Ponder throwing a catchable ball to Halstead.
They've all been catchable.
Yeah, but he really took a little off that one. He made sure he could catch that thing.
Thompson goes in motion. Ponder looks the other way. Pump fake, throws deep. Wide open, Smith, touchdown. Well, if you drop that one, you don't even bother to go back to the sideline. A perfect throw, and he's wide open.
Watch Smith as he comes out and he keeps his shoulder pads, bottom right of your screen, keeps his shoulder pads down, draws the corner up, and then that's a really hard ball to throw and an equally hard ball to catch. Because it's supposed to happen.
Yes, it is.
I've dropped those.
What's supposed to happen doesn't always happen. We've already seen that. But the Seminoles are back even at home, 14-14 with North Carolina.
Kowalczyk.
Emergency, Kowalczyk.
What is your emergency?
The intern forgot the donuts for the status meeting.
Bingo. It's okay. I'm on a mission. Professional driver, closed course.
Bang.
That's right.
we put a turbo in a sport cross. The all-new Nissan Juke. Innovation for success. Innovation for all.
During its first year, a humpback calf and its mother are almost inseparable. She lifts her calf to its first breath of air, then protects it on the long journey to their feeding grounds. One of the most important things you can do is help the next generation. At Pacific Life, we offer financial solutions to accomplish just that. Ask a financial professional about Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed.
The buzz is building. Music superstars will gather for country music's biggest night. The CMA Awards with Lady Antebellum, Sugarland, Keith Urban, Taylor Swift, a special duet by Miranda Lambert and Sheryl Crow, and the country music debut of Oscar winner Gwyneth Paltrow. The country can't wait.
Thank you so much!
For the CMA Awards, live Wednesday, 8, 7 Central.
Hosted by Brad Paisley.
And Carrie Underwood.
On ABC.
14 minutes, 15 seconds to go. First half of play in a 14-14 tie.
All right, now
North Carolina and FSU.
Mike, we talked about a concern in the secondary for North Carolina. Kendrick Burney, you see him bite as he's looking into the backfield, and he sees Ponder with a fake pump. He bites hard, and he comes up. Now, Burney's now, this is just his second game back, and this defense in the secondary especially, they've had some concerns and rotations back there.
Well, the guys that weren't dismissed or suspended or held out have been hurt. It has been an unbelievable list of people who have been involved in attrition, particularly in the secondary.
So you lose your technique. You know,
absolutely.
You just don't, your feel for the game. It's only a second one back. And Ponder threw for 395 yards last year on Thursday night against North Carolina. So he's had success. You knew that's going to be a challenge coming in the game.
When they were all healthy and available. Searcy. Taken down at the 27. They'll start from there. Yates has played really well early in this ballgame. So has Ponder.
See if Mark Stoops can dial up a little bit of variation here for TJ Yates. The defense today so far, you know, they've given up two already.
And only one in the first four games. So the idea of John Shoup coming out, throwing out of running formations and running out of passing formations has been very successful here in the first half. End around, drone. Caught in the backfield, taken down for a two-yard loss. They put in Sean Drone, who 2 years ago gained over 800 yards and has lost his job to Johnny White. Tried to fool him, and it didn't work. The Seminoles, they are so fast, it is very difficult to do misdirection against these guys.
Yeah, I think the passing game is going to be the best shot for North Carolina against this defense today. They will not have a consistent dose of running against Florida State's defense.
Yates with time throws underneath. Is it a catch and a fumble? Seminoles think so. Now an official comes in and says incomplete. It was intended for Dwight Jones. The officials are taught if there is a question of whether it is a catch or not, rule it incomplete.
Yeah, and Jones has to turn with it completely in his hands. I don't think he made a full complete turn with the ball. Bradham is right there. As soon as Jones touches the football, he turns up the field. He'd not made the complete turn. Nice job by the officials.
Third and long for Yates. They backed out of the blitz. Yates throws on a run to White, and White drilled immediately. Only got a couple of yards out of the play before Nigel Bradham, the weak side linebacker, took him down. And Florida State right now saying, listen, we can get some pressure with four coming after the quarterback. We're going to drop seven and not give you anything.
Yeah, that was a coverage sack there. And this is that defense that leads the nation in sacks with 33. They get over four a game, so you don't want to be back there holding the ball too long.
No. Fiegels to kick to Reed. Another low returnable kick. Reed's been close, but just hasn't been able to escape good pursuit by the Tar Heels special teams. 2 yard return that time after a line drive kick of 32.
Hey, boss. Do we have Aflac?
Nah, we have something else.
But if you're hurt and miss work, does it pay cash like Aflac does?
Nah.
Or let you spend it any way you want, like for gas and groceries?
Nah.
Or help with everyday bills like Aflac does?
Nah.
There's Aflac and there's everything else. Visit Aflac.com for an agent or quote.
Aflac!
You chose me for something. I will stand and fight.
Positive.
Positive.
We're gonna have a baby.
Now, when I was a little boy, at the age of 5,
the four-door sports car, Nissan Maxima, innovation for daddy. Innovation for all.
Get a new Maxima for 1.9% APR plus 500 cash back.
ABC Tuesday at 10, 9 Central.
Detroit PD, open up!
The cops of Detroit 187.
Detective Fitch, I need to set up a perimeter.
Are back on the streets.
Welcome to my playground.
Proving that this is one of the season's best new shows.
Jam behind the back.
Oh, that's good.
It's rock solid.
I know you didn't mean to kill her. Give me the gun.
Hey, Rihanna, what are you doing?
Don't.
ABC's Detroit 187. All new Tuesday at 10, 9 Central on ABC.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by AT&T, Rethink Possible. Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy. And Rogue Skyline, this Friday, our first encounter will be our last stand.
All sorts of good stuff at homecoming.
Mike, as often as you and I call these Florida State games, my fourth one, we may want to rent a condo here in Tally.
I'm surprised you didn't have a float today. Thomas. Across midfield, flag is down as well. And it will come back. Chris Thompson able to turn the corner. That was probably why.
Holding, number 82 offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Still first down.
Willie Halstead, the wide receiver, the second penalty he has been flagged for in this game. It is a really good running game, but no one in particular doing a particularly good job. Thomas, Thompson, and Jones, all with about the same number of yards, virtually the same average. And Jimbo Fisher says somebody gets hot, they stay in. They have all been hot at various times of the year. Ponder's been hot almost all year. That was almost picked off. Should have been. Denora Searcy really had a bead on it, had it right in his hands.
Yeah, and you know what? Christian Ponder just didn't see the free safety in the middle of the field. And he didn't recognize that it was back there. And very lucky this isn't a turnover. This has been more or less a sloppy half. Now, 6 of 11 drives combined in this half have been 3 and outs. And yet you got 28 points going. So just a lot of sloppy play. You get a good first down run, it's holding. You know, it's just sloppy.
How was that for closing speed by Searcy, able to undercut the route from his safety spot? Plan run, quarterback, Ponder. Across the 40 to about the 41. He doesn't mind taking punishment.
He tries to give it out.
Yes, he does.
And it's cost him sometimes with the nicks along his body, shoulder, elbow, tricep. But that is an element of this offense that really opens up a defense.
Third and call it 6. from Florida State 40. Ponder with good protection again. Halstead! A perfect throw, dropped it right over his shoulder and beat LeCount Fantroy. 40 yards. Boy, he's thrown some pretty balls.
North Carolina coaches use the words, we hope the light comes on at some point for Fantroy. But Christian Ponder is going against any corner. It doesn't matter who it is out there right now. And when you give him time, you see the accuracy and the proficiency of Ponder's throwing.
Halstead, a 6'3 sophomore who has improved dramatically this year. Ponder wants to keep it again. Goes airborne and gets down to the 16-yard line where Bruce Carter, the All-American candidate and a linebacker, made the tackle. Carter is projected to be one of the first four or five linebackers taken in the draft. Very talented kid.
He's got those NFL numbers, 4.39 in the 40. You know, 440-pound bench. You put those kind of stats up there with a body size of 230 and can run, that's good.
Yeah, they'll find a spot for you. Ponder again, pitches it back to Thompson. Little option action. There's a late hit out of bounds, and here come the flags. There's just no reason for that. Deontay Williams, who accepted extra benefits this year and was suspended.
After the player was out of bounds, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 27. The penalty is half an inch to the goal. First down.
Preseason All-ACC just makes a silly mistake.
Just got to leave him alone. You're past the white chalk. I mean, you're out there. It's over. Now, in two games back, he's been very aggressive, has 23 tackles, interception, forced fumble. I mean, he's playing hard football, but you got to play smart as well.
Yeah, sure do. And the way Ponder's throwing, he doesn't need any help. Automatic first down, first and goal from the 7. Jermaine Thomas, the new tailback. Ponder instead on the flanker screen. Easterling, touchdown. Taiwan Easterling just kept fighting for yardage and got it in the corner of the end zone. Kendrick Burney had a chance to make a play and couldn't.
This is all about formation. You're going to see the linebacker 54 walks back up and gives them the numbers on the outside for Ponder to throw the football. 54 Carter came in, gives them the numbers on the outside, throw it out there for a shot at a touchdown.
Point after makes it 21 to 14. Out of 17, 140 yards and 3 touchdowns for Christian Ponder. His team's up by 7.
That wasn't sloppy.
They'll go back to the eye with Curtis Byrd, the fullback, in front of Drone. And Drone off the right side spins, has a first down. When you get your starter at running back hurt, Mr. Former Running Back, and you put in the second string guy, does it tend to make your play calling just for that moment a little bit more conservative?
We saw on first down, John Shoup went right to him, gave Drone the ball. They have total confidence in Drone. He's a good, proven player. And if you're Drone, you know that you've got to now pick it up. You see your starting running back teammate going to the locker room. He's down with his shoulder. Now it's your game. You got to pick it up, and you got to take advantage of the opportunity.
North Carolina's season is basically on the line right here. Yates throws underneath, has it complete. That's going to be a first down to Adams, and Joshua Adams making moves inside the 20 to about the 17. They've lost 2 games in the conference. They cannot afford to lose a third and still make the ACC championship game.
Well, John Shoup is so good at formations and moving and hiding receivers. That time, Adams is on the inside, and you see him as an inside slot receiver, and the play action takes place. Everybody scatters following the middle of the field and just finds the flat. Good job by Yates, knowing where he's supposed to go with it.
They have had their most success when they have tried to cross up the FSU defense. Show them one thing and do another. Yates takes off, gets out of bounds. A very smart play back there by LaMarcus Joyner. He could have had a shot at Yates at the sideline. Mm. And he went, no, it's not worth popping him and maybe getting 15 yards. It's a very good decision.
15 yards in the wrath of Mark Stoops.
Yeah, oh, yes.
Stoops told me before the game, said, look, Craig, we got to really be careful about all this stuff because they will move formations and do things like they are on this drive trying to get openings. You've got to make sure you stay disciplined on your job.
Everybody in tight on second down, and Yates is going to throw out of it. Blitz coming. Got the completion to Anthony Elzey, and Anthony Elzey into the corner. How about that? Elzey with his first touchdown of the season.
Boy, there's a lot of movement, but what a beautiful job. Cam Holland, the center, 65, getting out front. He's in there, he's hidden, he gets out, and he's able to provide the block that clears the receiver to get out in the field. Does he step?
Stayed in bounds.
Oh, man, he just stayed in there. Wow.
And again, everybody was in tight on that formation. 9 times out of 10, you're going to run it. That time, they threw the screen pass. It works for a touchdown. John Shoup and the offensive staff has done a great job today for the Heels.
God.
Is that what I think it is?
Every city in the world is experiencing the same encounter.
Those things are coming for us.
There's not going to be many of us left.
Somebody's fighting back.
Run! Everybody get down!
We have to survive.
Skyline. Rated PG-13. In theaters Friday.
USA Prime Credit. My name, Peggy. You have problem?
Peggy? Okay. Lost my car. Need a replacement sent to my hotel tomorrow.
1 month.
Let's try this again.
Do you believe in yourself?
Yes. I believe in you too, Peggy.
You could be my go-to guy.
Or girl. Now stand tall and get out
to replace my card.
You inspire me. 3 weeks.
Okay, let's start over.
Want better customer service? Switch to Discover and get the help you need when you need it. It pays to Discover.
Fast keyboard, a turbo texting web jetting super you. The Droid X, a 4.3-inch screen. Summon movies and games at your command.
Now buy a Droid 2 by Motorola for $149.99 and get any phone free.
There's no question that it hasn't been easy. The mood and the atmospheres, the uncertainty, the X and O aspect of dealing with who might play, who could play, who will play, and trying to get the team prepared.
Waits, time flashes, incomplete. LSU wins it.
And there is the ball game. And for the 10th straight year, North Carolina loses its ACC opener.
It's hard to imagine starting your football season without 13 players that you had counted on. And that's what happened to North Carolina. 10 of 16 DBs have missed games. They were 0-2 at the start. Since then, they've won 5 of the last 6, held opponents under 15 points a game, and scored almost 26 themselves. They're right in this one with Florida State.
And lost a coach, John Blake, brought a new coach in for him. I mean, so this has just been amazing what they've done.
Reed on the return has a seam up the middle to the 35. Zach Brown made the stop on special teams. And now the Seminoles will go back to work with 6:50 to go in the first half.
It's been kind of one of the really good.
Kicking team number one. 5 yards will be added to the end of the run. First down.
Two offsides penalties on kickoffs.
Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of the way the game's been. It's been either really a well-played game or a bad one. I mean, you have 12 possessions, six possessions were touchdowns, 6 were 3 and outs.
And bad news for North Carolina. White has been diagnosed with a shoulder injury. We are told his return is doubtful. Ponder on a run, got it to Reed, and Reed nearly had it taken away by Kendrick Burney, who had a shot at it, thought he was going to end up with a football.
Now, Burney saw it, he read the right route, and the receiver coming into his area and went to it. But I thought he could have made a play on the ball and the receiver at the same time and not just gone for one. So, you know, that's just two games back.
Ponder again comes to the near side, complete to Halstead. And he's out of bounds at the North Carolina 37-yard line.
I felt coming into this game, this would be an absolute challenge for North Carolina in their secondary and the passing game with Ponder. They're going to have to change it up. They can't just rush four. They're going to have to bring five or six. They cannot allow Ponder to sit back there and throw it.
Ponder flanker screen again, this time to Easterling. And Easterling has a first down before he's pushed back. They'll mark it near the 32-yard line for a first down.
I did this game last year on Thursday night, and Christian Ponder, I would say, Mike, that he likes playing against North Carolina.
Apparently.
And North Carolina had him. I mean, this game last year, after really three quarters, it was 24-6. North Carolina.
Ponder having a huge first half. That pass just off the fingertips of Halstead. Catchable would have been tough.
The reason I think that he misses it, his body's moving away from the football that's gone more to the inside. And any good receiver would tell you, hey, I got two hands on that. I've got to bring it down.
Ponder throwing to his wide receivers. He's been able to throw it to guys who are open, and that's one thing he has done throughout his career. He has not been focused on particular guys. If you're open, he'll find a way to get you the football. Of course, he's human. You drop three or four in a row, you may not get another shot anytime soon.
All right, money down here. North Carolina's defense. We'll see if Everett Withers dials up something a little bit different.
Third, call it six. Ponder with four wide receivers. Three-man rush. They drop eight. Ponder wants to run for it himself. Has the first down and more. Christian Ponder to the 14-yard line. He's not shy. He'll take off if it's there.
See if I can show you 54, Bruce Carter, who's right here, okay? Now, let's follow him a little bit here, because as this play develops, Carter drops off, and he's really spying Ponder. See how he's spying there and the receiver who comes across? And he just did it. Ponder did a nice job of just saying, hey, I've got good feet. I'm going to go get this first down.
And he did. First down from the 14, Thomas. Can't get outside. He'll lose one, maybe 2 yards. And Deontay Williams came up from the safety spot.
Bad shoulder, bad tricep, bad elbow, bad wrist. Ponder keeps moving north on the all-time passing list here at Florida State.
Just passed Danny Cannell and Gary Huff in this ballgame. He is now fourth all-time behind Winky, Ricks, and Weatherford. Ponder with good protection. Screen to Thomas. Thomas down near the five. They need to reach the four for a first down.
You know, Mike, this is an offensive line. Now, they should be given some credit and love here in the first half, because they had to replace Brian Stork, their right guard, out with an illness. And they brought Sanderson in, number 73, playing over at right guard. And they've done a nice job today of allowing Ponder to throw these balls down the field.
That was the first catch for Florida State, not by a wide receiver in this ballgame. And the Seminoles will take a timeout at the 3:51 mark.
So you want to talk about the lovely guys catching the ball. I'm talking about the offensive line, Rick Trickett's guys.
Saturday Night Football has a Pac-10 flavor and a big showdown coming. Number 15, Arizona. Number 13, Stanford. Saturday Night Football, presented by Southwest Airlines on ABC tonight at 8 Eastern. 7 of the Nation will see number 12, Missouri, and Texas Tech. go to ESPN.com and search maps to see where you can find the game that you want.
This is a telling month. This conference play, and you get a lot of emotional rivalry kind of games. I just saw on the ticker going below, Iowa State leading Nebraska. We've seen a lot of teams ranked that were supposed to have been doing well at parts of the games today. Eventually, the ones who are supposed to win, the talent takes over, but Iowa State on top of Nebraska.
What a game would that be for Iowa State? They've already beaten Texas. How many years can you back they beat both of those guys? Thompson returns as the tailback on third and a yard. He goes in motion. Ponder gives it straight up the middle to the fullback, Lonnie Pryor. And he's in for the touchdown. The last time they ran out of that formation and sent Thompson in motion, Ponder threw the ball. This time they crossed him up and Pryor went straight up the middle.
The sixth, the different starting offensive line combination in the last nine games. Nobody was able to penetrate that offensive line, and the new match for Rick Trickett, the offensive line coach, works.
Seminoles with a 7-point lead with 3:47 to go in the half. For Lonnie Pryor, his second rushing touchdown of the season, and it gives his kids the lead. Lonnie Pryor with the touchdown run. So Florida State does to North Carolina what the Heels have tried to do this year. They crossed him up, gave him one formation, and gave him a play you normally wouldn't see out of it. Or hadn't seen before, at least in this game. The offensive coordinators enjoying this a lot more than the defensive coordinator. Well, we had to get the shovel brigade out there because the horse was on the field during the break.
I've stayed up in the booth. I haven't been down.
You don't sign up for the student manager to do that, do you? And this one will go out of the end zone. I mean, it's one thing carrying a bag of footballs. It's another thing to be going out there with a shovel. So I don't know.
Well, this has been a very interesting half of football. I'm impressed with North Carolina showing up, T.J. Yates doing his thing. But Christian Ponder clearly has forgotten the mistakes that were made the previous two games. He's come out and directed an offense. Once the receivers started catching the ball, doing a really nice job.
I'm not saying a word. I'm just impressed with the guy with the shovel. Carolina still with plenty of time here in the second quarter. And Yates wants to throw. Little screen. It was tipped and incomplete. And it was Brandon Jenkins that appeared to have got a hand on it. Well, let's go back and give you the answer to our Aflac trivia question, which was, who was North Carolina's last 1,000-yard rusher? And the answer, Jonathan Linton, 1,004 yards in 1997. And if you want to bake a cake and mail it to Jonathan Linton, his birthday is tomorrow. He will be 36. Wow. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Second and 10. Yates over the middle. And he completes it to Adams. And Adams right at the sticks. They need to get to the 30. Jenna Jay made the tackle, and it is a first down.
Boy, very impressed with T.J. Yates. Hadn't seen him yet this year in person. Compared to the past, he just looks more decisive with his throws. You know, and right now, Stoops is rushing four on that defensive line and dropping seven in coverage. No pressure on Yates, and he just feels good about where he's going with the ball.
Had a monster first half, 217 yards on 12 of 17 throws. Play action fake to Drone. Good protection for Yates. And a good decision. He just throws this one out of bounds. Let's check back in with Robert Flores. Robert?
All right, Mike, here's what's happening on SportsCenter right now, presented by Discover. Number one, Oregon, starting to find their stride against Washington. Darren Thomas, 34-yard score. They lead UW 18-6. And watch this touchdown catch from Drake Dunsmore. Beautiful one-handed catch. Northwestern leading Penn State 21-zip. Joe Paterno sitting on 399 career wins. Mike.
You know, Robert, when Joe says he doesn't care about 400, I believe every word he says. But we care about 400. Love to see the man get it. The sooner the better. Yates. Drone on the screen. It's the second time he slipped trying to make a cut. Got it up to the 38-yard line. Alan Pelk. Out in front, threw him a nice block on that screen.
So here you go with a John Shoup out there. Got a little NFL background to him. He likes those screens, and that's going to really put pressure on Mark Stoops to figure out something against it. But it gets him to that third and short, which that screen was designed to do. Get them in either first down or manageable third.
Clock running, 2:19. Third and two, Carolina trying to keep the drive alive. Stack the receivers to the near side. Yates with time, throws underneath, got the first down to Jones. And he's out of bounds to stop the clock at the 2:02 mark.
That's the respect Shoup has for that Florida State defensive line, moving that pocket, making sure he didn't sit back there with a chance to get popped right in the mouth. And it's either going to be run for a first down by the quarterback or he dumps it off easily to his receiver, Jones.
Well, your job as a coach, isn't it, to put guys in positions to succeed? And that time, they needed 2 yards. He got Yates on the outside, able to make the easy throw and pick up the first down. Drone is in there because Johnny White has been hurt, if you joined us late. Again, complete to Jones. He's whacked just short of the first down marker. Coming up on the Capital One Halftime Report, John Saunders and Jesse Palmer, highlights and scores from a busy day in college football.
Man, how about Jones? How hot is this guy? You know, coming into the game, and you mentioned it earlier, 20 receptions
this season, and he came into this game ninth in the country in sacks.
You know, we ended the second quarter with Brandon Jenkins getting a sack and saying, okay, I'm out here, fellas. You guys better be prepared for me. And, you know, if you're not taking care of number 49, you have a blown assignment before the ball snapped.
Well, they ended up double-teaming the tackle and letting him go. He's the one guy on the line you can't let go. Yates never had a chance, got him from the blind side. Fakes the draw. Yates will try to do it himself. Blockers in front. T.J. Yates down to the 27-yard line. It's enough for a first down. Yates had only had a 10-yard run as his long for the season. This breaks it.
He missed opportunities and tackles at the line of scrimmage. And you saw Vince Williams, 11, the linebacker, come off into coverage. Yates ran right by him.
Nobody will confuse him with Cam Newton, but he got the job done. Drone cuts it outside, and that was a solid tackle by Bradham.
Number two on the team in tackles, and the one thing about the Florida State linebackers, when the unit is playing well together, their linebacker level is filling their lane and what they call their foxholes in Mark Stoops' defense. They're in their hole. You don't want to get in there with them.
Second and six for T.J. Yates in the North Carolina offense, driving to try to tie this game. Yates on a roll and in trouble again. Down he goes. Marcus White, the other defensive end, give him 5.5 sacks on the season. and the third for the Seminoles this afternoon.
Okay, now watch again. Now here's what's going to happen. Watch how good a job that White does with his body. And look at, see how he's moving. He's moving. He's going. He's staying. His feet are active. And that's the word the coaches use about him. Hey, he's an active player. Leads by example.
Very athletic as well. Third and long. They need to reach the 18 for a first down. Yates throws too high, intended for Ryan Taylor, his H-back. Right now they're trying to use four guys to make up for the loss of Zach Pianalto, who was a tremendous tight end. Broke a leg against Virginia.
He was. Boy, what a loss. I mean, but again, you lose one of your best players on top of what all they'd lost earlier, and you just, hey, let's keep going, fellas.
They've lost one of their best players time after time after time after time this year. And now they're going to try to go for a long field goal. This will be a 46-yard field goal attempt by Barth. And the kick is good by Barth. That is his long of the season. And Barth cuts the lead to four.
Once that adrenaline starts pumping, you just gotta embrace it.
Bear Grylls is the ultimate man of adventure.
Can he take on my sport?
My sport.
My sport to the next level?
I challenge.
I challenge.
I challenge
Bear to take on the chain of adventure.
We got one shot at this.
Amazing.
Woo.
Let's give it a go.
Watch me take on the chain of adventure at DegreeMen.com. Degree for Men Adventure Antiperspirant.
It won't let you down.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome back to the much-anticipated matchup between the Eagles and the Bulldogs. Hold on. I'm not quite sure what we're seeing right now, but cows are parachuting onto the field. I cannot believe what I'm watching. Two cows landing on the field. There's a third headed into the stands. It's actually headed right towards a burger. Look out! Oh, my. That's going on the highlight reel.
Good news, sir. I just got an email from the office, and word is people really love our claim service, especially the Auto Repair Express. Repairs are fast and are guaranteed for as long as you own your car.
Hey, that's great. Is this your phone?
Yeah, of course.
But where do you put... I mean, how do you carry...
Here you go.
Thanks.
No, I got it, sir.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
This week on ESPN's Monday Night Football, the Steelers head to Cincinnati to face a hungry Bengals team. Steelers and the Bengals on ESPN Monday Night Football, 8:30 Eastern. Coverage starts at 7. Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's. Heels close to within four and now have to kick it away to the Seminoles, and Reed is deep again.
Kicking off for North Carolina, Casey Barth.
Heels playing for their season right now. Remarkably, they are still in the hunt. Reed stays on his feet, dives out to the 25.
Brad Reed on the return.
We said coming into the game today that Christian Ponder had to forget the six turnovers in the two previous outings that he had. You see the zip on the ball right there, Mike? You and I, we watched him against Boston College a couple of games ago where he had the bruise and the bursa sack. He's getting the ball to the flats with zip and pest on the ball. and doing a nice job of not making mistakes today.
Those passes to the sideline against Boston College took forever, and we were speculating at the time that he might have been injured. Little did we know he had burst a bursa sac. Go with the ground game to Lonnie Pryor, who scored a touchdown today. It was an unusual formation. That looked like back in the day with split backs.
Back in the day, would that be like in the back of the day of my day?
Yeah, absolutely. You remember that.
Yeah. Used to be called the pro set.
You'd have a halfback or two, a halfback and a fullback or two halfbacks. Yeah. Yeah. Neither one of which wanted to block for the other.
Yeah, nobody wanted to block. Give me the ball.
Ponder fakes it this time. And again, right on target, and a perfect throw to Halstead. Halstead has been very, very active, picked up a couple of penalties, but he's picked up a lot of yards as well. That one was for 26. Five catches, 101 total for Halstead on the day.
Yeah, while you admire the route and the throw, I'm going to talk about the offensive line. This offensive line coming into the game, it was told by us, Jimbo Fisher said they're not doing a good job of pass protection. So far in this game, they've done a really nice job of pass protection, and they had to replace their right guard, Brian Stork, who's out with an illness, with Ronnie Sanderson.
They were doing a good job on the short stuff, but when Ponder needed time, he wasn't getting it. Fake the end around, good fake by Ponder. Now he's under pressure, and there's an example of what Jimbo Fisher was talking about. That pocket collapsed, and Quentin Copels came through and stuffed the quarterback.
Woo, do you see the speed now? Again, I said to you in the first half that Copels was moved from defensive end to inside at tackle because they had no depth inside. This is the burst that Copels has. When he gets off the hands, there he's going. The athleticism. He now has 6.5 sacks on the season. Plays behind the line of scrimmage a lot.
And when he catches you, you stay caught. Second and 20 for the Seminoles. This time they'll give it off to Thomas. And Thomas across the 45 to about the 46. Paige Moss makes another tackle.
What Florida State has to guard against is playing conservative, because North Carolina has nothing. They've got everything in the world to lose nothing. You know, they can't hold back at all. So they're going to fire at you, North Carolina, in the second half. And Florida State's going to have to keep the ball moving down the field like we saw the previous play on a nice pass deep.
Thomas is the tailback in that split back set again. Three-man rush. Covering very well in the secondary, and now Ponder taken out of bounds.
And it's a lot of white jerseys dropping into coverage wisely. I mean, it's third and a long distance here. So Everett Withers, the defensive coordinator over at North Carolina, has done a heck of a job in this ball game. When he had the opportunity to get off the field, he's gotten his team off.
You know what? You consider all the guys that Coach Withers has lost this year, and the teams that he's facing, the good offense that he's facing, the fact that he's not giving up 50 a game is a tremendous job. This one they'll be able to pin inside the 10. Good kick, good coverage. They'll mark it at the 8-yard line. A 44-yard punt, no return, and North Carolina will take over from there.
XL Chalupa. Double the beef, loads of nacho cheese sauce and tons of toppings in a monster chalupa shell. It's so big, you better call in a closer.
Don't worry, kid. I got it.
Go get him, Mo.
Nope. Think outside the bun.
Would you like
like her to rephrase the question.
I'm not going to be the person I'm expected to be anymore.
Bien expected. Bleu de Chanel.
At Chanel.com.
ESPN's College Football on ABC. Brought to you by Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. And Cooper Tires. Don't give up a thing.
Part of the homecoming festivities last night here at the Civic Center in Tallahassee, where the Seminoles basketball team plays.
My Thursday partner, Jesse Palmer, really wanted to come to town to judge that dancing competition last
night. Did he?
He just missed out.
Yates throws to his H-back, Ryan Taylor. And Ryan Taylor with a big gain out to the 35-yard line. Let's check in with a score update in the studio.
All right, Mike, AT&T All-America Player of the Week update. Michigan State's Edwin Baker. He's a nominee. 179 yards, four touchdowns as the Spartans handled Minnesota 31-8. You can text VOTE to 345-345 to take part and for a chance at a trip to the national title. Mike.
Right, he's a pretty good football player, and that's a pretty good team. Yates wants to go deep again, has a man wide open, Jones. And Jones inside the 10 to the 7. That's the second big play that Yates has hit Dwight Jones. That's 56 yards for Jones. And if there is a wide receiver in this country who is as hot as Dwight Jones, I'd like to see him.
And as hot as a quarterback right now. Look at Yates. He buys time, moves the pocket, excellent job protection up front, and there's no excuse at all for Nick Moody and the safety to get someone behind him.
Drone has a hole off the left side in the five, inside the five, driving to the three.
You know, North Carolina opened this football game up with a big throw down the left side. Play action on the first one, play of the game. And they have kept it going the entire ball game. Now, this is a Florida State defense that's very aggressive against the run, but now they've got to readjust their minds. They got to realize that North Carolina is getting it done throwing the football. They got to be respectful of it.
Dwight Jones, 183 yards receiving today. 183. Drone again, hitting the backfield, taken down near the five. Penetration by Marcus White and Jacoby McDaniel.
Well, this is a very good red zone defense against touchdowns. They've given up only 11 out of 25 trips this season coming into the game. That's respectable. You're going to have to do something down here to earn your way in for 6 points.
Third and goal, like play action here, straight drop back. What do you like? Going to go under center, tight formation. They have thrown out of this formation successfully. Play action fake. Pass, touchdown, Adams. When you have a tight formation, you draw the defense in with you and gives the guys on the outside of that tight formation room to operate.
Mike, this is twice we've seen Adams now because of formations by John Shoup. You're going to see him. He's the number two receiver to the inside. So it's really hard for guys out there defending. You got number two. You better get out there with him. And the timing, Yates, get the football. Get it out of your hands.
You're stuck on the inside. He's outside. They throw it there, and it works. T.J. Yates has thrown for 331 yards and has just put North Carolina back on top.
With it. Ponder just has to guard against forcing something. It's okay to punt and let your defense get out there and try to stop T.J. Yates.
Three-man rush. Ponder trying to buy some time. Throws on the run. It's going to be intercepted at the 40-yard line. There is a flag down. Merletti picked it off. The holding call may go against Carolina.
Number 98 defense. Roughing the passer.
15 yards from the previous spot. First down.
Going to call Paige Moss for roughing the passer on a play that could have turned this game around.
For 98 defense, holding number 77 on the offense. Those penalties were offset. We'll replay second down.
Oh, how huge is that? That's an automatic first down.
Ooh, 45 seconds ago, I just said Ponder has to guard against throwing a bad ball down
and
the field.
And he just did.
And you just can feel it. Now, this is, you know. But this Florida State offensive line that I've been praising, they're falling apart up front, aren't they? Now we're seeing what they were talking about, Mike. Now that the pass is out there, now that Florida State or North Carolina has figured out they're only hurting us with the pass, they're pinning their ears back and they're getting back to Ponder in the backfield.
Well, that kind of stuff's just uncalled for.
Yeah.
So you pretend it didn't happen. They want a screen. They let everybody through. Throw the screen to Thomas. And Thomas crosses midfield. They're still going to be about 20 yards shy of a first down.
Okay, this is a fantastic call by Jimbo Fisher on second down with a screen against a very aggressive front four. It's a very impressive job by the seven men in white jerseys getting to the football.
Yes, it was. Kevin Reddick, the middle linebacker, was out there. He was in on the tackle. Zach Brown was in on the play. Thomas had blockers in front, but didn't do a real good job of setting them up. Still third and a mile. Four-man rush. Good protection. Underthrown and incomplete. Crowd wants a flag. They're not going to get it. Matt Merletti came back, knocked the ball down. It was intended for Rodney Smith, but the ball was underthrown. Smith actually had half a step on the safety.
Well, you know what? When your name is Merletti, his dad, Lou, was a part of the Secret Service who protected three different presidents. What's the big deal in guarding a wide receiver?
ESPN's presentation of college football on ABC will return after this message and a word from our ABC station is in there right now.
Man, I always enjoy watching a John Shoup called offense because he uses everybody. He moves formations, and it's just a really creative way of calling a game.
He's made some great calls today going against tendencies. Yates goes deep, has a man complete down to the 35-yard line. Again, it's Adams. Joshua Adams got behind Terrence Parks. How many big plays is North Carolina going to hit FSU for today?
All right, here's goes Shoup. Now, again, you're going to get in motion. Look at 49. The H-back comes across, and he blocks the end man of the line of scrimmage, allowing the ball to develop down the field, making sure you protect the quarterback, moving the pocket. Again, you see these moves in the secondary and the coverage of Florida State, again, having white jerseys behind them.
Boy, Parks is lucky they didn't hit the receiver in stride or he's gone, because Parks was really, really out of position. And now here comes a flag at the end of this play. That might be a helmet to helmet.
After the player is out of bounds, personal foul, number 29 defense, half a distance to the goal, and the end of the run, first down.
Kendall Smith, the middle linebacker, called for a hit out of bounds.
Well, I can tell you a group of fans who are also cheering about this would be somewhere along North Carolina State Way, who lost today to Clemson, had the edge coming in this game with Florida State. They drop one, so they're sitting at home cheering, hoping that Florida State goes down one. That play, I agree with you, Mike. I mean,
when a guy's right on the edge, how do you pull up? That's what I'm asking.
That's a tough one.
When you use replay, he was obviously out of bounds. But if you're playing, that's pretty tough. Elsie. Elsie. A lot of pushing and shoving going on after every play now. McLeod made that last tackle.
Now we're seeing down in here again, this red zone defense, Florida State, that has been very strong this season, has had a hole in them today because of formations. And we've been able to watch and see number three, Joshua Adams, now a couple of times being hidden inside and coming out as a number two receiver and wide open.
Seminoles have been pretty good in the red zone. Today they have been vulnerable. Elzey on the draw. Inside the 10, drilled as he got to the 9.
Now I can tell you that in film study, there was a big hole that was there, but Elzey playing in now for the injured Johnny White was late getting to the quarterback. And that's just because he's not been doing it. You're going to see, watch if we can here, you're going to see how he goes a little bit too far to the left, and he's late getting back there. The hole is up in there. He's supposed to be beyond number 90. That's not supposed to be a player in that play right there. He's supposed to be up at the linebacker level with the football.
They'll send him out as a wide receiver this time on third and long. They need to reach the 4 for a first down. Yates over the middle, incomplete. There is a flag down, however. Dwight Jones, who has had such a brilliant game, stopped and nearly had that pass picked off because of it. And it's going to be a motion penalty against North Carolina. Jones was coming
up. Formation on the offense. 5 men in the backfield. That penalty will be declined. Fourth down.
Jones was coming across the middle, and when he stopped, the quarterback has no choice. He's already thrown the ball.
Yeah, exactly. And this is a little different look when you got three receivers to the left-hand side. And they come out and they look single. They're hoping they can get their star receiver of the day, Jones, to keep moving across, catch the ball with a chance for a first down.
Casey Barth will try a 26-yard field goal. He has already connected from 46. And North Carolina increases its lead to 6, but there's a flag down again.
Number 80 was in the backfield. 5 men in the backfield. 5 yards. Replay, fourth down.
Two straight illegal formation penalties, and they'll have to try the field goal again.
How about Butch Davis? You know what? Go ahead, try
it.
He's been through so much in his life. You don't get that hollow, empty feeling anymore, that seed that says, oh, what's next? Just like, hey, line up, kick it again.
This will be from 31 yards for Barth, who is 8 out of 10 this year, including 1 this afternoon. No flags this time, and North Carolina increases its lead to 6. 34-28 with 11:41 to go.
But a great job by that Florida State defense of limiting them to 3 points.
ESPN College Football on ABC, presented by K Jewelers.
¿Me quieres casar conmigo? ¿Te quieres casar conmigo?
Will you marry me?
Before saying those words, there's one word every man should know.
Leo.
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 The Leo Diamond at K Jewelers. A fire, sparkle, and brilliance so intense it is the first diamond ever certified to be visibly brighter. One more reason K is the number one jewelry store in America.
Dangan, si.
Yes. Every kiss begins with K.
After he refused to stop playing GoldenEye, Todd Wilson's wife ordered him to sleep on the couch in the basement. The basement where he kept GoldenEye. Well played, sir.
GoldenEye's back. Get your friends. Rated T.
Tucker Alexander. He turned down an epic Hawaiian hot tub party for a multiplayer paintball tourney. Oozes before jacuzzis, as they say.
GoldenEye's back. Get your friends. Rated T.
From the outside, you can't appreciate the wraparound contour of its 12-way power driver's seat. Or the ice blue interior LED lighting. From the outside, you can't enjoy the standard USB and Bluetooth connectivity. But once you're behind the wheel, that's when you discover the beauty of the sport-injected 2011 Regal. For
from Buick. This heroic dog saved her entire family, and Sunday, the Extreme Team's gonna raise the woo.
A doggy demo!
ABC's Extreme Makeover Home Edition, all new Sunday at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
Surprise!
Mom! Dad!
The Powells may be extraordinary, but with the in-laws, they've met their match.
Is there something you two want to tell us?
ABC's No Ordinary Family, all new Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
The country can't wait for the CMA Awards with performances by the biggest stars in country music, hosted by Brad Paisley and Carrie Underwood, live Wednesday at 8, 7 Central on ABC. If Sugarland is going to perform, I'm there, and Sugarland is going to perform.
I had a little Lady Antebellum carrying me through my workout this morning.
Ooh.
I like them.
Reed is deep. Florida State, which got an earlier gift today of its two contenders in the division losing, now in danger of dropping back with them, and they get a break here.
Ball replaced at the 40-yard line. First down.
North Carolina kicks it out of bounds, and the Seminoles will start at the 40. And Barth really upset with himself. He's checking with Robert Flores. Robert?
All right, Mike, here's what's happening on SportsCenter right now, presented by Discover. Number one, Oregon starting to pull away from Washington. Darren Thomas, look at the move right there to get into the end zone. Ducks leading 39-16. Number six, Alabama gets the go-ahead touchdown from Mark Ingram. They need number 10, LSU, 16-13.
Ponder right back on the attack, completes a pass to the 40. Willie Halstead with another grab. He's had a big day. Deontay Williams knocked him out of bounds. Seven catches for Halstead.
Yeah, he really has stepped up. And early in this game, the Florida State receivers were not catching the ball clean. And Halstead started being one of the guys, finally said, okay, enough's enough. We're going to catch the football.
Seven catches, 127 yards. And boy, has Ponder been good. Plenty of protection deep down the middle. Was he in or out of bounds? The officials looking at each other. No. Reed caught the pass, but they said he was out of bounds.
Oh, I think his right foot seemed to have come down first, just after the back end line. But there was no safety back there, so Ponder let it go. There's no possession yet. The left foot is down. Left foot is up. While possession is there, right foot down. Nice call.
He had beaten Bernie, made the catch, but does not get the foot down.
Wow. Game of inches, isn't it, Mike? Oh. I mean, that's just crazy. But what a throw. No safety back there. Ponder went ahead and let it go.
Now second and 10 from the Carolina 39. Four-man rush. Halstead goes way up the ladder to make that catch. Zach Brown nailed him.
That's the way you do it, though. If you want to find a way to keep your team in the ball game and to stay on top of your division race, you go up and you give your body up and you help your quarterback.
Yeah, but you go back and you tell him, listen, yeah, I've had these ribs for a long time. I'd like to keep them a little longer.
All right, third down, money down.
They need the 29 for a first down. Ponder drops the snap, gets it right back. He can run, got the first down, and dives to the 25. If he sees an opening, he's gone. He's not going to hit you for 80, but he'll hit you for a big 5 or 10.
Yeah, okay, now what happens here is Quentin Copel's number 90 on the defensive line. He's coming around, but he doesn't quite get there. He's watching the ball on the ground. He was supposed to bend all the way around the outside for that outside containment. He was caught watching the ball on the ground and didn't do his job.
First down, Seminoles. As we approach the 10-minute mark. Thomas down near the 21-yard line. Remember, this drive started after the kick was out of bounds from the 40-yard line. So the Seminoles have not had to go this far, only 39 yards to be in this position. Three wide receivers. Thomas is the single setback, and he'll get the carry. Dragging tacklers with him down to the 18-yard line. Tydreek Powell, number 91, was the first man in that defensive swarm to drag him down.
You know, Jimbo Fisher was talking about his offensive line and having the confidence in them on running the ball on second and a fair amount of yards to get the job done against North Carolina's front seven. And, you know, now he comes down to where he has the option of doing play action or running the football.
It'll be third and a yard and a half. Thomas. Room to the outside, first down and more, and a flag down at the end of the play.
Holding, number 88 on the offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
Usually when you see someone run to the outside and there's nobody there to stop him, somebody's holding.
Well, you see number 88 in line of the scrimmage. I thought they'd call it on the outside of the wide receiver, which was not going to be holding in my opinion, but you've got cloth, and when the defender can't get away from you, there's usually a reason. Well, we've seen now several mistakes by Florida State's offense, whether it was drop balls or procedures, right, critical times, just putting them in a bind.
Now there's a huge play here. Third and eight. They are within field goal range, but do you want to settle for a field goal or do you go for it down here? Blitz coming. Ponder hangs in the middle and throws, and it's right through the hands of Reed. Six drops. Had to turn the other way, but still it looked like a pass he should have caught.
It's absolutely, and you know what, it is turning the other direction, but Burt Reed is a guy that's going to make that catch most of the time. And you could see that Ponder realized blitz was coming in his face. He took something off the ball, not accurate all the way, but he took something off. Reed usually would make that play. And I'm agreeing with Jimbo here on this thing here. You know, don't chase points right now with 8 minutes to go in this quarter. You got to depend on your defense to go make a play.
Chris Thompson, the player that was shaken up for Florida State, limping as he comes off the field. And the field goal unit is on. Sean Powell to try a field goal that would cut it to three. Plenty of time left in this game, 7:56. There you see the specialist, Dellenbach, the snapper. Powell, the punter, is the holder, and Hopkins on to try the field goal from 42 yards. And he missed it.
And the kick is no good. It remains North Carolina 34, Florida State 28.
So the Seminoles still down by six, and North Carolina gets the ball back with 7:51 to go.
From the outside, you can't tell it's equipped with a direct injected engine. From the outside, you can't appreciate how its variable valve timing optimizes power and fuel efficiency. But once you put your foot to the pedal, that's when you discover the power of the sport-injected 2011 Regal from Buick. And now lease this 2011 Buick Regal for $249 per month.
Lucky team flag.
Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you from mayhem like Allstate.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 57th President of the United States.
The nation's fastest mobile broadband network, AT&T.
AT&T. Rethink possible. The new BlackBerry Torch with a slide-out keyboard for $199.99. Only from AT&T.
Today's AT&T All-America Flashback, Graham Harrell. On October 4th, 2008, this Texas Tech quarterback led his Red Raiders to a decisive road win over the Kansas State Wildcats, completing 75% of his passes. Harrell led a potent offensive attack that saw him throw 454 yards and six touchdowns as he became the school's all-time leader in passing yards. Text VOTE to 345-345 from your mobile phone to vote and for a chance to win a trip to the national championship game. ESPN's College Football on ABC. Brought to you by K Jewelers, the number one jewelry store in America. Every kiss begins with K. The sport-injected 2011 Buick Regal. And Ally. Do you love your bank? Learn more at allybank.com.
Big plays have hit North Carolina State where it hurts. A dropped pass and then a missed field goal have really taken the air out of this place. Florida State, excuse me. You're North Carolina, you'd love to maintain control of the ball right here. What a catch! Down to the ground goes Dwight Jones and picked it off the top of the grass for 19 yards.
Yeah, this young man has stepped up today. Here it is on first down. John Shoup saying, look, we have a lead, but we're not going to run right into a wall. We're going to throw, and I've got confidence in my quarterback, T.J. Yates.
Well, they may have to throw. They've only gained 41 yards rushing in 21 tries. But Jones is up to 202 yards receiving, and in the last four games,
time to further review.
The last four games, he has nearly 600 yards as a wide receiver. That's almost 150 yards a game. Now they'll take a look at this and see if they've got a better angle than we had.
Indisputable video evidence is needed, and at that point right there, there's nothing.
Further review, running on the field stands.
Good job. Way to go, officials. Hey, I mean, in and out of there. Keep the game going.
For Dwight Jones, already the fourth best single game performance ever for North Carolina. 202 yards receiving.
And, you know, how about T.J. Yates? He's now had five 300-yard passing games. Now here he is with the third one this year.
He has been spectacular today. First down from the 43. Yates again. Now under pressure and down he goes. Well, I gotta love the play call. I mean, you come out, you figure you need something to win this game. Let's go for it.
Well, here's what they were going for. They were going for a home run. You had a four-man rush. The linebackers were up, and they were really tight. And Yates is looking deep down the field. His eyes are deep. And there's only one receiver, one option deep, and everybody else was covered underneath.
Second and 15 after the sack. Yates near side, incomplete. It was intended for Eric Highsmith. First time they have thrown his way today, and Yates missed him badly.
Here's the problem with having such success throwing the ball. Over 400 yards now for T.J. Yates. But now it's a part of the game. You need to be able to run the football. And coming into this football game, they were running for 136 a game. But when you lose your number one guy, Johnny White, it makes you one-dimensional.
And Drone has been nowhere to be seen. They have gone to their third tailback. Elsie, we've had no report on Drone. So your top two tailbacks are gone. Pretty much kills your running game. Yates gets out of bounds. Boy, there's another good decision made by the Seminole tackler, Nigel Bradham. He could have unloaded on Yates, but it was right at the sideline. Discretion is the better part of valor.
And this is called great teamwork. This is a smart defense because as Yates got to the outside, did you see him wanting his receiver? If that corner had peeled up to support the run, he would have dumped it over him.
Fiegels to punt. The first time North Carolina has been forced to punt in a half. All the way play back inside to five, and Fiegels picks it up and kicks it out of the end zone. That's going to be a safety. Holy cow.
The penalty is for illegally kicking a grounded ball in the field of play. That penalty will be accepted. Half the distance to the goal from the spot of the foul. Penalty carries a loss of down. First down.
In the field of play with the kick of the ball. I mean, this is a disaster before the kick's even there. And Fiegels is back there and kicks it at about the 3-yard line. That's why it's half the distance.
Well, I know what he's thinking in his mind. He's kicking it out of bounds thinking it is a safety. I know in the NFL,
yeah,
it would be.
Yeah, you kick it, but it was not. It was in the field of play.
Exactly.
An infraction in the field of play. That's just a bang-bang play. And, you know, it's a few yards. Your head's not on right. You're not thinking. How many times, Zodiac, are you faced as a punter with something like that?
But what a turnaround. They would have been able to punt the ball perhaps inside the 10-yard line and make FSU go 90 yards. Now you've got Thomas on first and goal, a tailback. You give it to the fullback. Pryor, touchdown. Holy cow. What a stunning turnaround. The snap over the head of the kicker, Fiegels, gets down to the 3-yard line, tries to kick it out of the end zone for a safety, but because he kicks it within the field of play, it is a penalty, and Florida State takes over. Oh, man.
Well, Mike, you know what we said a while ago? The team with the ball at the end probably has the best chance of winning this football game. And this is one of those deals where you're not confronted with that as a punter. Now, I know his dad punted for 100 years in the NFL, but his dad probably never had that kind of deal. How about Jimbo Fisher thinking, where's the gift coming from? Wow.
Christmas comes early.
ESPN College Football on ABC, presented by K Jewelers.
Dear Corolla, I know, change is hard. You never considered making Bluetooth remote keyless entry and turn-by-turn navigation available in every model. So it must be hard for you to hear AutoWeek.com say our interior raises the small car bar. If you want to talk about it, call me. That is, you know, when you get home, since you don't have Bluetooth in every model. The all-new Chevrolet Cruze, starting under $17,000. Get used to more.
Once that adrenaline starts pumping, you just gotta embrace it.
Bear Grylls is the ultimate man of adventure.
Can he take on my sport?
My sport.
My sport to the next level?
I challenge.
Bear to take on the chain of adventure.
And we got one shot at this! Amazing! Woo! Let's give it a go!
Watch me take on the chain of adventure at degreemen.com. Degree for Men Adventure Antiperspirant.
It won't let you down.
Everything we've learned has come down to this. The next generation of MacBooks.
Are things different now that I'm not crushing quarterbacks every Sunday?
Yeah, a little bit. But I still have a taste for greatness.
So I love Dr. Pepper. The taste of these 23 flavors can never be equaled. Like me.
Pizza perfect nab.
I got it.
Donovan.
Mike? What? Mike. Come on, Mike, man.
Still got it.
There's nothing like a pepper. Trust me, I've sent people to the doctor. Oh.
The chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup at Texas. Tomorrow at 3 Eastern on ESPN.
That's the long snapper, Mark House, on the left. Unfortunately, you never mention the name of a long snapper unless he makes a mistake. And he did make one there. And then Fiegels compounded it, thinking he was going to get a safety. Instead, the Seminoles get the ball on the doorstep. A devastating play, a one-point Florida State lead. Harrelson on the return. Todd Harrelson spinning off tackles out to the 23-yard line. 5 minutes and 43 seconds to go in this game. Can North Carolina recover?
You know what, Mike? We call a lot of football games, and you just seldom see in college football where a punter near the goal line has to make a decision like that.
Right.
You know, it's one of those bang-bang decisions you have to make. And if you don't do it all the time, you can't expect it to be an automatic, conclusive decision by your punter. Oh, you know, pick it up and do something with it. But
yeah. Well, if he picks it up and throws it, it's an incomplete pass. But he's thinking, I'm kicking it out of the end zone. We'll give him the 2 points. North Carolina first and 10. Elzey is drilled as he crossed the 25 to the 26. And the statistical downside of that bad snap is because now they have 0 yards rushing for the entire game, and now they're trying to do something on the ground with Elzey, their number three tailback. This is tough.
What's not been tough, though, is yards through the air. Over 400 for T.J. Yates and plenty of time in this game.
You looking for Dwight Jones like I am?
Yes.
He only got more than 200 yards today. Instead, they throw underneath. Elzey. About a yard shy of a first down. They need to get to the 33. And Butch Davis is over there at the sideline yelling at the official, standing on the 33 while the official marks it on the 32. And he's saying, hey, up here, up here.
He's on up there. Now, here's what you have to really be concerned with, though, is you've got a defense that leads the nation in sacks that is pinning its ears back. At home, their crowd really into it right now. And so this offensive line in North Carolina, they're gonna have to really, really focus on technique.
Look who's down, Elzey. They're just running out of guys. Curtis Byrd is the other guy who has been playing. Let's take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. And the two quarterbacks have been absolutely sensational today. Ponder, 21 of 31, 3 touchdowns. 239 yards passing. And T.J. Yates, the much maligned senior quarterback of the North Carolina Tar Heels, 22 out of 32, over 400 yards and 3 scores. His career high, by the way, 412. He has 408.
This might put, if there are no other running backs out there that can do it, may force Butch Davis and John Shoup into an empty set. Looks like maybe they've gone with perhaps Ryan Taylor, an H-back hybrid guy.
Hunter Fur, number 40, is in there. Taylor is an H-back. They have been using him as a tight end. He's a pretty good receiver. There's Fur, who's a sophomore out of Louisville, North Carolina. Sophomore, 6 feet, 210. They got the first down. Play action fake by Yates. Under pressure, he's going to throw it away. Boy, he's made some, not only has he made some great plays, he's made some exceptional decisions today, and I think that was one of them.
Like that right there. The safety stayed back that time for Florida State, trying to go deep and down the field to Dwight Jones, 83. That's been successful a lot tonight in this ball game. But the no throw, and that's just such a good job of managing the situation.
Which is what he was really heavily criticized for last year, Craig. He wouldn't do that. He'd throw the ball downfield, try to force it in, had 15 interceptions a year ago. There may be a point where he's going to have to force it here, though. Second and 10. and it's caught again by Jones, and Jones breaks the tackle inside the 35-yard line. Mr. Alexander had him and lost him, and Dwight Jones picks up another 31 yards. This guy is awesome.
Okay, now watch the left side. John Shoup again having the number two guy, 83. You're going to see him over there. See how he comes in across just lazily. There's the scrape and the rub by the pick, if you will, that comes across from number three, Adams, and it clears it out. The play was designed to make sure they had third and short, but it turned into a big play because of your run after catch.
Eight catches, 233 yards, the second best day a receiver has ever had in North Carolina football history. Fur, the tailback, trying to cut it outside, cuts back inside, down to the 32.
Boy, how about Fur? There's a guy right there that comes in and picks up a nice 3 or 4 yards for his team. Probably had no idea whatsoever he'd ever even get in the game today.
Absolutely
hey, Mom,
not.
Mom, Dad, don't come. I'm not going to get in. Yeah, you're in Carolina. Moms and dads better show up. They might miss a play.
Haven't seen Curtis Byrd recently either. So the top four listed running backs, tailbacks and fullbacks are out. Here goes Fur again. He's got a first down. He's down to the 20-yard line. Ryan Taylor and Alan Pelk led the way.
You know, and Alan Pelk is just back after last week. Probably could have played last week, but he had a bad shoulder. But you see big number 70 out there clearing the way. Fur getting up in there. I mean, John Shoup is telling us right now in the country, hey, I'm going to run my offense. I know what the defense has given me. Now it's up to whoever's in there to do their job. Fur's doing his.
This is really amazing. 2.5 minutes left. Fur straight up the middle, 5, 10, still on his feet.
I'm going to tell you what I've been most impressed about at this point with Fur carrying the football. Watch how he protects the football. In the heat and the traffic, that ball is securely tight. Two hands on the football, protecting the ball. That's awareness. And you know, most of the guys who come off the bench and don't get, you know, hadn't been lathered up, they're not aware of what they're out there doing.
Clock running, 1:58 to go. They are in field goal territory. All they need is to work on the clock and set it up. Elzey is back in, gets the carry.
Jimbo Fisher needs to call timeout here. He's got to start saving this clock. He's got to save the game, give himself a chance.
.128. Second and goal. Florida State with all three timeouts left. They're going to have to start using them at some point. Elzey is the tailback. He gets the carry. Stopped at the 4.
But, and you got to be smart here, and you understand why they're not throwing it, right, Mike? I mean, you don't want to take a chance.
Absolutely.
You know, and so, you know, you just want to make sure that you keep the ball where your kicker can have a very nice shot. Good hands play today. There's no doubt who that goes to. That's number 83, Dwight Jones, who has had a record day. Came in hotter than a firecracker, wasn't he, Mike? I mean, he came into this game totally on fire and has now pushed that streak, continues on as the go-to guy. 233 yards, 29.1 average. Mark Stoops, the defensive coordinator, he's seeing number 83 jumping over his bed tonight.
Hunter Furr is the other guy I want to talk about. He comes in, three carries for 27 yards. All year, he had had two runs for two yards. He comes in a game that they have to win to stay alive, gets three carries for 27 yards. How about that?
And hangs on to the ball. Nice job.
Elzey is in there now on third and goal. They wind the clock. 1:05 to go. And out of bounds. Boy, Yates had his eyes fixed in the end zone. Looking. But he goes out of bounds, so Florida State doesn't have to burn a timeout. A mental mistake by T.J. Yates, something he hasn't done all day.
I almost pulled a hamstring up here trying to slide for him. I mean, it's just, you know, you got to force him to. That is a really big, critical mistake by T.J. Yates.
This will be a 22-yard field goal try for the lead. Barth is 2 for 2. He's hit from 31 and 46. This a chip shot. And North Carolina is back on top. 37 to 35, leaving the Seminoles 55 seconds and two big timeouts left.
Well, I'd recommend that if you're interested in this game, you're not going anywhere, because I don't think it's over. They just need a field goal attempt, right?
The Droid 2, a lightning-fast keyboard. A turbo-texting, web-jetting Super U. The Droid X, a 4.3-inch screen. Summon movies and games at your command.
Now buy a Droid 2 by Motorola for $149.99 and get any phone free.
Dear Focus, be careful out there. As you know, we have more standard safety features than you. 10 airbags, daytime running lamps, OnStar automatic crash response. In case you didn't see it, that's probably why MSN Autos called the Cruze the class of its class right now. That seems pretty clear, doesn't it? The all-new Chevrolet Cruze, starting under $17,000. Get used to more.
Impressive resume.
Thank you.
Do you know what? Tell me, what makes Peter Peter?
Well, I'm an avid catamaran sailor. I can my own homemade jam, apricot. And I really love my Banks Raise Your Rate CD.
I'm sorry, did you say you love a pay raise ASAP?
No, actually, I said I love my Banks Raise Your Rate CD.
You spent 8 days lost at sea.
No, I never.
You love watching your neighbors watch TV.
At Ally, you'll love our Raise Your Rate CD that offers a one-time rate increase if our current rates go up. Ally, do you love your bank?
Bless you, and with you. Appreciate everything you're doing. And hopefully you'll all come home soon.
Join ESPN in support of our troops, wounded warriors, and their families. Donate $10 by texting USO to 27722 or go to www.uso.org. I've had the rare privilege of being around a lot of our wounded veterans in the last 3 or 4 years, and I can tell you how much donations like that would mean to them and what they are still going through coming back from the war zone. It would be so deeply appreciated, you wouldn't believe it. ...55 seconds to go in a huge ACC game. Reed had some nice returns across the 40. Midfield. Still on his feet, and Reed's out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Holy cow.
I just felt the air pop in Raleigh, North Carolina. North Carolina State not wanting this. How about Reed? Guy started off the game, almost had a fumble on a critical play. Comes back, explosion, setting up Christian Ponder to do what he needs to do to get them down for a field goal attempt.
That's all they need, and Dustin Hopkins has a great leg. He's kicked 52 yarders twice. They would only need the 35 to give him a shot from there, 10 more yards. But they're not thinking a 52-yard drive or a 52-yard try. They want something a little closer. Underneath, only going to pick up a couple. Crowd questioning that throw because the clock's going to continue to run. Got to hurry, wasting too much time here, especially with two timeouts left. Ponder throws. That'll get him a first down and stop the clock to Halstead.
Hell, if you want, you can clock it.
49 yards.
You got to clock it right now and save your two timeouts, but get reloaded. But you definitely get it. Get the clock stopped. There you go.
That cost him 1 second. Well executed.
Yeah, well executed. You know, so that saves those in your pocket with two, and it gives you a chance to throw the ball and do a lot of other things.
Yeah, you want to keep the one timeout to bring the field goal team on, so you're not rushing that.
Yeah, very good job there. This allows you to have an 8 or 9 yard run up the middle, screen, something that's in the middle, right, short of a first down.
But 44 is no gimme. Ponder, Halstead, boy, used up an extra couple of seconds there. But he made the catch, got the first down. From here, it would be 37 yards.
Well, it's 37 instead of 41, because at the end of this play, Halstead, when he caught the ball, hits the defender and went 4 more yards. That's a big difference.
Florida State will use a timeout. Now, they want to talk about this because another play is risky. Here's why this is so big. Florida State with a one-game lead over Maryland and NC State in the loss column. They both lost today, giving the Seminoles a chance. North Carolina is 2 games behind Virginia Tech in the loss column. They've got Tech next week. They could cut the lead in half. But if they lose this game and have 3 losses in the Coastal Division, their chances are pretty much shot.
Well, last week, this Florida State team on a Thursday night against North Carolina State was down, about to win the football game. Play action, tight end wide open, and a crazy fumble on a play action. Ponder has brought his team back now and has to make one more play to give themselves a chance to win at the end of this ball game.
Now they're trying to get it to the other hash, and they put it right in the middle.
And they've been down here before, not long ago, and missed.
And what happened?
It wasn't a good result.
42 yards. But Hopkins has been very reliable this year. Powell is the holder. Dax Dellenbach, number 64, will snap it. Spotted at the 23-yard line. It's going to be probably 40 yards.
And Butch Davis is standing over there. He's got 3 timeouts. I'm sure he'll try to work a little bit on the head of the kicker.
He's going to use one of them.
Timeout, North Carolina. First charge. Timeout will be 30 seconds.
It all comes down to Hopkins.
Early in the season, North Carolina was concerned, been working on their kickoff, punt coverages. How big was the kickoff return? I mean, it's just humongous that Greg Reed takes back up the middle of the field to give him the steal.
Sure was.
I mean, it's just phenomenal.
Try to find number 54 for North Carolina. His name is Bruce Carter. He has blocked 7 kicks in his career. 7. Certain guys have a knack for blocking kicks. And Bruce Carter right now is thinking number 8 and saving this game.
Two timeouts. North Carolina. They have two remaining.
A 40-yard field goal to win it for Florida State. North Carolina survives the reliable Dustin Hopkins, misses two field goals late, and North Carolina clings to a 37-35 lead. I bet you nobody in their heart really thought he was going to miss that kick.
Are there any hearts left in the stadium?
Maybe not.
Because, you know, when you talk about this Florida State team, one thing that Jimbo Fisher's tried to convince them of is to focus and finish. And 2 weeks in a row, right on the doorstep of a victory, hearts plucked away twice now.
And they go right back in a three-way tie in their division, and North Carolina somehow is still alive.
That's the end of the game. North Carolina 37, Florida State 35.
And the Tar Heels have come back from so many near disasters this year.
Good luck with you. Back to you too, guys.
And Butch Davis deserves heck of a lot of credit for the way he has held this football team together.
You know, congratulations, you're right, Mike. This sports teaches a whole lot of lessons in life.
Yeah.
And those guys over there, Butch Davis and that staff and those players, have learned a lot about life this season.
Butch Davis, can you hear us?
I do hear you.
Butch, it's Mike Patrick, Craig James upstairs.
Hi,
tell
guys.
You what, hats off to you, man. You have done a heck of a job.
Well, let me just tell you something. I heard somebody just say a while ago, kids learning lessons in life. And I tell you what, you got to absolutely love this group of kids. They just refuse to surrender, to give in the face of all kinds of adversity. Our coaching staff, the assistants did a phenomenal job, and kids just keep playing hard, guys, and you got to love them.
Hey, Butch, tell us about one guy.
Yes, sir.
Hunter Furr, who had had two carries all year long. I mean, you were running out of guys to carry the ball. He comes on the field and got three big runs for 27 yards.
He really did, and I tell you, obviously, Hunter's a kid that we recruited a couple of years ago, had a great high school career. Playing behind two really good running backs, and he came in cold off the bench, and you got to love him. I mean, he ran hard, he protected the football, he knew what was at stake. But I tell you who really deserved a lot of credit was that offensive line, those tight ends. They knew we needed to knock it in down there and give him a chance, and they did a great job.
Butch, you've coached football a long time. What has this season taught you and meant to you?
It's kind of hard to put in words, guys. It just, you know, I mean, the resilience of these kids. I mean, you coach football because you love kids, and you coach them because you in good times and in tough times, and you love to see their will and their belief in each other to just stand up against all the odds and the adversity and hang in there, and they'll remember these things for the rest of their life. That's what college football and that's what college sports teaches kids.
Butch, congratulations to you and your kids on a great win.
Oh, thank you guys very much.
All right, congratulations, Butch.
Thank you.
Take a look at the standings, and this does change a lot of things. In the Atlantic Division, Florida State, Maryland, NC State, all with two losses. In the Coastal Division, North Carolina is two games back in the loss column to Virginia Tech, but they play Virginia Tech next week. They can cut it to one, and the way things are going for North Carolina, you'd hate to pick against them, you know?
Well, there isn't a coach in this conference that wouldn't tell you that on any given Saturday you can lose, and we'll let the beat continue, man. You see if Florida State can find a heart to show up next week.
Once again, the final score, North Carolina 37, Florida State 35. Don't forget, at 8 Eastern, 7 Central, we'll be back with Saturday Night Football regional action. Just check your local listing. For Craig James and our entire crew, this is Mike Patrick. Thanks for watching, and so long from Tallahassee, Florida.
Something colossal is coming. An event that will bring the biggest names in music together for one incredible night. The CMA Awards with Rascal Flatts, Keith Urban, Kenny Chesney, Zach Brown Band, Lady Antebellum, Taylor Swift, a duet with Kelly Clarkson and a country superstar, and the country music debut of Oscar winner Gwyneth Paltrow. The country can't wait.
Thank you so much.